Good afternoon. Today we will solve some problems on root locus. Question is, overall transfer function GFHS is given by K divided by S plus 1, S plus 4. Plot the root locus plot for this system. So there are three poles, one at s is equal to 0, other pole is at s is equal to minus 1, and third pole is at s is equal to minus 4. So this is the pole 0 plot at s is equal to 0, at s is equal to minus 1, and at s is equal to minus 4. Since there is no open loop 0, it means there are three branches, and all the three branches terminate at infinity. And angle of asymptote, so we calculate the angle of asymptote along with all the three branches terminate at infinity, is given by 2n plus 1 multiplied by 180 p minus z. Here n is 0, 1, and p minus z minus 1 is 2. Value of n is 0, 1, and 2. For n is equal to 0, we get angle of asymptote is 60. For n is equal to 1, angle of asymptote is 180, and for n is equal to 2, angle of asymptote is 300. These are the angle of asymptote. Then find out the crossing point of these asymptote, which is given by centroid. Sum of real parts of 4 minus sum of real parts of 0 divided by p minus z. It means that sum of real parts of 4, 0 plus minus 1 minus 4, it means 5 divided by 3. Number of pole is 3, number of zeros are 0. So this is the centroid minus 1.66, and this centroid is given by minus 1.66. Then you calculate the number of branches. Here you calculate the number of branches, angle of asymptote and centroid. Then you calculate the breakaway point. Breakaway point is where multiple roots occur. Means this root locus branch starts from open root poles. So this branch starts from this pole. Second branch starts from this pole, and at this breakaway point, these two roots, there are two roots on the real axis. Then calculate the breakaway point, and breakaway point is given by first find out characteristic equation, which is given by 1 plus GSHS is equal to 0. And this is the characteristic equation. If you differentiate this characteristic equation with respect to s and substitute dk by ds is equal to 0, then you get this equation, and calculating the roots of equation, we get the roots minus 0.46 and minus 2.86. Yep. But in this region, root locus lie because to the right of any point in this region, sum of poles and zero is 1, which is odd. So root locus lie in this region. There is no root locus in this region because to the right of any point in this region, sum of poles and zero is 2, which is even, so there is no root locus in this one, in this region, and there is For the same reason, there is a root locus in this. Breakaway point always lie on the root locus. So this breakaway point is on the root locus, but this breakaway point is in between minus 1 and minus 2. So because there is no root locus, it means that this is not a valid breakaway point. Then from this breakaway point, these two roots tend to infinity. Yeah. And this is the asymptote. Angle of asymptote is this angle is 60, next angle is 180, and third angle is 300. So this is the asymptotic line, and angle of asymptote is given by 60, 180, and 300, and this is the centroid. This branch, these two branches starts from open loop pole with k is equal to 0, with k is equal to 0, and after breakaway point, these two branches terminate at infinity along the asymptotic line. Then last one is calculate the this intersection point, and this intersection point of root locus and imaginary axis is given by Rao theorem. Form the characteristic equation, and from this characteristic equation form Rao theorem, and substitute this term is equal to 0 to find out the value of marginal, to find the marginal value of k, and marginal value of gain is 20. Since this rho is 0, when we substitute the value of k is 20, this rho is 0, so we form an auxiliary equation from this rho. 5s square plus k is equal to 0, and find out the root. These are the roots, and this is the intersection point of root locus with imaginary axis. What is breakaway point? Breakaway point is a point on the root locus where multiple roots of the characteristic equation occur for particular value of k or gain. These are the two open loop poles. So root locus starts from this and from this pole, and at this point there are two roots, and from this breakaway point these two roots become complex roots. So we can say that breakaway point, or we can define breakaway point where branches break into complex. Branches break into complex form from real is called breakaway point. And break-in point, if these are the two consecutive zeros, so these are the branches which, this is the breakaway point, and the point where branches break into real part. These are the complex roots. These are the complex roots, and from this point they become real. So the point where branches break into real from complex is called break-in point. Between two consecutive zeros there is a break-in point, and between two consecutive poles there is breakaway point. And break-in point or breakaway point can be calculated simply by forming characteristic equation, then differentiate that characteristic equation with respect to s and substitute dk by ds is equal to 0, and calculate the roots of equation. Next question is, draw the approximate root local diagram for a closed loop system whose open loop transfer function is given by gshs is equal to k divided by s plus 5 s plus 10. Comment on the stability means first find a first plot the root locus, and from that root locus give comment on stability of the system. There are three fourths, number of zeros are zero, so total number of branches is three, and all branches terminate at infinity. The starting point of branches 0, s is equal to minus 5, s is equal to minus 10, with k is equal to 0, and terminate at infinity. This is the 4-0 plot. S is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 5, and s is equal to minus 10. These are two consecutive poles. It means that in between this region there is one breakaway point. Then calculate the angle of asymptote. In angle of asymptote is given by 2q plus 1 multiplied by 180 divided by p minus z. Q is 0, 1, 2, 4, 3, 2. Value of q is 0, 1, and 2, and 4, 3. Q is 0. Angle of asymptote is 60. Next angle is 180, and last one is 300. And calculate the centroid. Centroid is sum of real parts of 4 minus sum of real parts of 0 divided by p minus z. So minus 0, minus 5, minus 10, minus 0 divided by 3, which is minus 5. Centroid is at minus 5. This is the angle of asymptote, and this is the crossing point. Crossing point is at minus 5, which is centroid, 60, 180, and 300. Then calculate the breakaway point. Breakaway point is 1 plus GSHS is equal to 1. This is characteristic equation. We get this characteristic equation and differentiate characteristic equation with respect to S and substitute dk by ds is equal to 0. This is the final equation. Calculate the roots of this equation. Minus 2.113 and minus 7.8. This is the valid breakaway point. In this region, there is a root locus because to the right of any point in this region, sum of zeros and pole is 1, which is odd. So, breakaway point lies in between, and invalid breakaway point is at minus 7. Since there is no root locus between minus 5 and minus 10, so this breakaway point is invalid breakaway point because the breakaway point always lie on the root locus. Or we can also verify that which point is valid breakaway point simply by substituting the value of this in characteristic equation. Substituting the value of breakaway point in this, k is equal to this. First, substituting the value of s is equal to minus 2.113 in characteristic equation. If value of k is positive, then that breakaway point will be valid breakaway point. So this s is equal to minus 2.11 is valid breakaway point. Next, calculate the intersection with negative real axis. Form the Routh array and In this logarithm, substitute this term is equal to 0. So we calculate the marginal value of gain is 750. Since if we substitute the value of k is 750, then this row is 0. Form the auxiliary equation from this row, which is 15 s square plus k is equal to 0, and calculate the roots of this equation, and we get plus minus j 7.07, and this is the intersection point of root locus with the imaginary axis. Intersection with the imaginary axis. So this is the complete root locus plot. S is equal to 0, S is equal to minus 5, S is equal to minus 10. This is the valid breakaway point, minus 2.113. This is the intersection point, plus J 7.07 and minus J 7.07. And these two roots starts from open loop 4 with k is equal to 0, means value of gain at this point is 0. Value of gain at this point is 0, and gain increases, and at this point value of k is 750. And when this point value of k is greater than 750, and these two roots break away into complex roots and tends towards infinity along this asymptotic lines, and third one tends to infinity along second asymptotic line at at 180 degrees. क्लियर है ये तुम लोग को? हेलो अदिति,
हेलो। यस मैम, क्लियर है।
ओके, व्हेन वैल्यू ऑफ के इज लेस देन 750, व्हेन वैल्यू ऑफ के इज लेस देन 750, द ऑल द रूट्स आर इन लेफ्ट हैंड, इट मींस दैट सिस्टम इज स्टेबल for k is less than 750, and if value of k is 750, it means that this is critically or marginally stable, and when value of k is greater than 750, system is unstable. State the complete root locus of the system having GSHS is equal to K divided by SS plus 1, S plus 2 and S plus 3. If there are 4 number of open loop holes, N is equal, P is equal to 4, no open loop 0, Z is equal to 0. All the 4 branches approaching towards infinity, and starting points are s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 1, s is equal to minus 2, and s is equal to minus 3. This is the pole zero plot. S is equal to 0, minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. These are two consecutive poles. So there is one breakaway point in between these two poles, and these are two consecutive poles, one breakaway point in between these two poles. First, you calculate the angle of asymptote. Value of Q is 0, 1, 2, 3, and for one, angle of asymptote is 45. For q is equal to 0, angle of asymptote is 45. For q is 1, angle of asymptote is 135, 225 and 350. Then calculate crossing point of these asymptotes, mean centroid. Centroid is given by 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, divided by 4 is minus 1.5. Then calculate breakaway point. Breakaway point means first calculate characteristic equation 1 plus GSHS is equal to 0, and this is the characteristic equation, and differentiate this characteristic equation with respect to S and put dk by ds is equal to 0. You get this equation and calculate the roots of this equation. In this case, note this point. If the open loop poles or and zeros are distributed symmetrically about a point on the real axis, then the point of symmetry is 1 on the root of this equation. Means, agar koi do open loop poles hain aur open loop zeros jo hain, ye symmetrically distributed hote hain kisi point pe on the real axis, then point of symmetry is 1 of the root of this equation. Means, इस इक्वेशन का जो है वो पॉइंट ऑफ सिमेट्री जो है एक रूट होगा दिस इक्वेशन. ठीक है, इन दिस प्रॉब्लम पोल्स आर एट एस इज इक्वल टू 0 एंड एस एट एस इज इक्वल टू माइनस 1. 0 एंड माइनस 1 मीन्स दीज टू पोल्स आर सिमेट्रिकली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अबाउट symmetrically distributed about 0.5, and these poles minus at minus 2 and minus 3 are symmetrically distributed at 1.5. So the poles 0 and minus 1 and minus 2 and minus 3 are symmetrically located about a point S is equal to minus 1.5. So this must be taken as first root of dk by ds. So we plot the from this equation. Write the coefficient of this equation 4, 18, 22 and 6. This is synthetic division method, and since S is equal to minus 1.5 is treated as a root of above equation, so here you write minus 1.5 and multiply this 1. This 4 is written here. Multiply this minus 1.5 with 4. So we get minus 6, and subtract this 12. Then multiply minus 1.5 with 12. We get 18. And subtract this. We get 4. And there's minus sign 4. And then multiply this, we get minus 6. 6 and 6, 6 plus 6 and minus 6 is 0. It means that this is the root of this equation. So we can write this equation 4s क्यूब प्लस 18s² प्लस 12 22s प्लस 6 इज इक्वल टू 0। इन दिस फॉर्म s 1.5, दिस इज वन रूट ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन, सो वी कैन राइट दिस एंड एंड कैलकुलेट द रूट्स ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन। वी गेट 3 रूट्स, s इज इक्वल टू -1.5 एंड -0.381 एंड -2.619। We know that there is no root locus between -1 and -2, so s is equal to -1.5 cannot be a valid breakaway point. These are the, if we substitute s is equal to point, s is equal to -0.38 or s is equal to -2.619 and this equation, then we get the value of k is 1, which is positive. So these are two valid breakaway points, and value of k is 1 at this breakaway point. Then calculate the intersection with imaginary axis. Simply form the Routh array and equate this term is equal to 0 to calculate the marginal value of gain. Here value of k is 10, and substituting the value of k in this equation, we get this row. The total row is equal to 0, so form the auxiliary equation, and from auxiliary equation find out the intersection point. All the poles are at 0, minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. This is the breakaway point, -2.619, and second breakaway point is -0.381. And this is the centroid, from centroid. This is the end. This asymptotic angle is 45. And 135. So, root locus branch starts from this open loop hole, and from this open loop hole in this, and approaching at this point, this is the breakaway point. There are two roots, and from this root, they tends to, from this point, root locus starts to tends to infinity, and similarly, root locus starts from open loop hole. Root locus starts from open loop hole with k is equal to 0, with k is equal to 0, and breakaway point, it is. Both branches tend to infinity along asymptotic line, and this is the complete root locus of the given system. When value of k is less than 10 and greater than 0, at this point value of k is 10, it means that value of k is less than 10 in this region, and all the roots are in left half. System is stable for k is less than 10, greater than 0, and when k is at 10, system is marginally stable, and when k is greater than 10, system is unstable. This k is the complete root locus for the system having having open loop transfer function. GSHS is given by k divided by ss plus 3 s square plus 3s plus 4.5. s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 3, and next two roots are minus 1.5 plus j1.5 and minus 1.5 minus j. This is the full zero plot. Then calculate the angle of asymptote. These are the angle of asymptote. Centroid. Real part of the sum of real part of the cone means 0 plus minus 3 minus 1.5 minus 1.5 divided by 4. And in this case, this is the centroid. Centroid is also at minus 1.5. And calculate breakaway point. Breakaway point is given by this. Poles are located symmetrically and point of symmetry is one of the root of this. And in this case, point of symmetry is point of symmetry 0 and minus 3. Point of symmetry is minus 1.5. Point of symmetry is at s is equal to minus 1.5. So roots of above equation, write down the coefficient of this equation 4, 18, 27, 13.5, and this is the root of equation or point of symmetry. So in this case, minus 1.5 multiplied by 4 minus 6, 12. Minus 1.5 is multiplied by 12, minus 18, 9, minus 1.5 multiplied by 9 is minus 13.50. It means that this is the root of this equation, and we write this equation in this form and calculate the roots of this equation, which is minus 1.5. Minus 1.5 means breakaway point is minus 1.5, and this is a valid breakaway point because if we substitute the value of s in characteristic equation, we get the positive value of k. And from this characteristic equation, form the Routh array, and this Routh array, in this Routh array, equate this term is equal to 0 to calculate the marginal value of gain, which is 25.3, and then form the auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is formed by 11.25 s square plus k is equal to 0, where s is equal to this, s is equal to plus minus j 1.5. This is the intersection point of root locus and imaginary axis. Angle of departure. Because in this case, roots are complex, so calculate the angle of departure. This is the one root, and this we have to calculate the angle of departure at the point. So this subtend 135 angle, this pole subtend 45 angle, and this pole subtend 90 degree, and so angle of departure is calculated by 180 minus 270, which is minus 180, and we can say that angle of departure is plus minus, angle of departure is minus 90 at minus 1.5 plus j 1.5 and plus 90 at minus 1.5 minus j 1.5. And this is the complete root locus. First cone, second cone, third and fourth cone. These are cones. So root locus branch starts from this. Root locus branch starts from this, and this is the breakaway point. Similarly, root locus starts from this with k is equal to 0. Root locus starts from this with k is equal to 0. And all occur at, there are at 1 minus 1.5, or we can say that there are four poles. In this case, there are four poles at S is equal to minus 0.5. S is equal to minus 1.5. And at this breakaway point, there are four poles. And these poles tends to infinity along asymptotic lines. Marginal value of K is, means value of K or gain is at this point is 25.3. So when value of K is less than 25.3, greater than 0, system is absolutely stable because all the poles are in left half. When value of K is 25.3, system is marginally stable. And when value of K is greater than 25.3, system is unstable. This is the last question. GSHS is given by K divided by S plus 4, S plus 2. So there are two poles at S is equal to minus 2 and S is equal to minus 4. 2. Number of asymptotic lines are 2. And angle of asymptote is given by 90 and 270, or N is equal to 0 and N is equal to 1. Centroid is minus, is that minus 3. Intersection point of asymptotic line is given by characteristic equation and differentiating this characteristic equation and equating dk by ds is equal to 0, we get this equation. And breakaway point is also at minus 3. Means root locus starts from minus 2 with k is equal to 0. Root locus starts from s is equal to minus 4 with k is equal to 0. And at breakaway point, these real roots become a complex pole and tends to infinity. Find the value of k at s is equal to minus 3. Means find the value of k at the breakaway point. How can we calculate the value of k at breakaway point? We know that 1 plus GSHS is equal to 0, so we can say that GSHS is equal to minus 1. And if we take absolute value of GSHS, we get 1. This is known as magnitude criteria. And in this equation, if we calculate angle of GSHS is plus minus 2 and plus 1, 180 means odd multiples of 180. It means if angle is plus 180 or minus 180, then this is known as angle criterion. It means that if for any point magnitude of GSHS is 1, means that point will lie on root locus. Similarly, for any point S is equal to any point, or for any point, if angle of GSHS is minus 180 or plus 180, it means that point will lie on the root locus. This is known as angle criteria and magnitude criteria. And generally, this magnitude criteria is used to calculate the value of gain at any point on the root locus. How can we calculate? Suppose that we want to calculate the value of k at s is equal to 3. Then GSHS is given by k s divided by s plus 2 plus multiplied by s plus 4. So calculate the mod of this. And mod of this according to magnitude criteria is 1. And substitute the value of S is minus 3. And from this equation, we get the value of K is 1. So we can say that at the breakaway point, value of k is 3. So when value of k is less than 1 but greater than 1, greater than 0, then that case is overdamped, because roots are real. When k is 1, it is the case of critically damped, and when k is greater than 1, k is in this portion, k is, value of k is less than 0, greater than greater than, value of k is greater than 0, less than 1 in this region. In this region, value of k is greater than 0, less than 1. So when roots are real, when roots are real, k is overdamped. At this point, this is the point of critically damped, and when roots are complex conjugate, then that case is under damped. Okay, time is over. In this case, these two roots and these two roots symmetrically situated at 1.5. This at the So time is over, and thank you. Thank you.